Hi, good morning everyone. Welcome to our definite integral chapter. Chapter definite integral. Then exercise 16C that we already started yesterday. So we are doing second part. So that is the same question of the assignments that I send next to you. Okay, so here I will discuss few questions. That was different type of concept covering your assignments. So here in this your third question. So third question, ninth part, is it? I is equal to 0 to a dx x plus a square minus x square. If it is a square minus x square, so we consider x is equal to a sine theta. So we here consider x is equal to a sine theta, dx is equal to a cos theta d theta. So after differentiation we will get a cos theta d theta. Now you have to change the limit because this is the limit of x. So if I change to theta, so I have to convert this limit into theta form also. So at x is equal to 0, so theta is equal to 0, because if you put 0 here, so a sine theta is equal to 0, so that means your theta is equal to 0. At x is equal to a, so a is equal to a sine theta, so that means your sine theta is equal to 1. When sine theta is equal to 1, when theta is equal to pi by 2, because sine pi by 2 is equal to 1. Okay, now you have to substitute value in the question. So in this my original question, if I just replace the value, so that is 0 to pi by 2 e cos theta d theta by a sine theta plus a square minus a square sine square theta under square root. Now you have to solve that one. If you take this one, a square common, so 1 minus sine square theta become cos square theta, square root will be cancelled, so it will be like that, 0 to pi by 2 e cos theta d theta by a sine theta. If you take a common after the square root also, so square root will be cancelled on a square, so 1 minus sine square theta. So 1 minus sine square theta is your cos square theta, and square and root will be cancelled, so only a cos theta is left it here. So I is equal to 0 to pi by 2 e cos theta d theta a sine theta plus a cos theta. Now if you take a common here, so a will be cancelled. So if you take a common from numerator denominator, your required equation become cos theta by sine theta plus cos theta. So this you consider as your equation number 1, because now we have to apply the property of a minus x here. So after applying the property, new equation becomes 0 to pi by 2 cos pi by 2 minus theta, then sine pi by 2 minus theta, then plus cos pi by 2 minus theta. Now cos pi by 2 minus theta changes to sine theta, and sine pi by 2 minus theta changes to cos theta. So my new second equation become, after applying the property, so that is sine theta cos theta plus sine theta d theta, and this is my second equation. Now what I will do, I will just add this first and second equation, because this is cancel it here. So now this is my first equation, this is my second equation. Now I have to just add these two equations. So this will be 2i. So if you look at this, now you have to adding 1 and 2. Equation 1 and 2 you have to add here. Equation 1 and 2. So this become 2i. So if you look at this, denominator is same. You just add the numerator and keep the denominator same. So 0 to pi by 2. So that becomes sine theta plus cos theta, and sine theta plus cos theta d theta. Now here if you look at this, numerator and denominator is same, so that will be cancelled, only one is left. So this is 0 to pi by 2 1 d theta, and integration of 1 is x, sorry, yeah, here it will be theta 0 to pi by 2, because we are not dealing with x, we are dealing with theta here. So here now when you solve further, so when you apply the value in place of theta, so that will be pi by 2, and my required I value will be pi by 4. So that is my answer. So next question is, here in this form, your xv, so that is your 15th question. So in this you have to find 0 to 1 integration of 0 to 1 limit log 1 by x minus 1, that you have to find it here. So here we apply again, first we take the LCM of this one, try to make the first equation before the property, so it will be log 1 minus x by x dx. So now you apply the property, we mark it this as equation 1. Okay, now you have to apply the property again, a minus x, so this in place of a there is 1, so a minus x means 1 minus x, you replace x with 1 minus x, so that will be 0 to 1 log 1 minus 1 minus x, because when you apply the property you just replace x with whatever upper limit is there, upper limit minus x dx. Now when you open, 1 minus 1 will be cancelled and minus minus plus, so your required term is 0 to 1 log x upon 1 minus x dx. So this is your second equation after applying the property. Now you have to add this two equation, add 1 and 2, so this will be 2 times I, so 0 to 1 log 1 minus x by x plus log x by 1 minus x dx. So I combine it, take common integral with limits. So here if log m plus log n, so log m plus log n, your logarithmic rule is there, if log m plus log n condition occurs, so that means it will be log m into n, so that is 0 to 1 log, now you have to multiply this two term and take log as common, so it will be like that. Now x and 1 minus x will be cancelled. So if you saw that only here log 1 is left and my log 1 value is 0, so in this case my whole I will be considered as 0. Now your next question is 0 to pi by 2, 2 log cos x minus log sin 2x dx. Now you have to integrate this with the limit, upper limit is pi by 2 and lower limit is 0. So what I will do, first I will consider this as my first equation. Now I have to apply the property, same a minus x property, a in place of a there is pi by 2, so that means you have to replace x with pi by 2 minus x. So before applying the property we mark it original equation as one first equation. So after applying the property, 0 to pi by 2, 2 log cos pi by 2 minus x, because this is a minus x property, that means pi by 2 minus x, pi by 2 is in place of a, so here it is log sin 2 pi by 2 minus x, pi by 2 minus x and dx, you just replace the x with whatever your upper limit minus x is there. Now here it will become 0 to pi by 2, 2 log sin x, because this is pi by 2 minus x give you log sin x, log cos pi by 2 minus x, log sin x, then minus log. So if you open that one, 2 will be cancelled, only pi is left, pi minus 2x, that becomes sin pi minus 2x, and sin 180 minus theta is lies in second quadrant, and that is positive and 180 degrees, so there is no change in the trigonometric term. So it will be keep as it is sine 2x, and that become 2 log x, 2 log sine x. And your required equation after applying the property is 2 log sine x minus log sine 2x dx. So this we mark it my second equation after applying the property. Now you have to add this first equation and second equation. So by adding this first equation and second equation, so that become 2i. Now when you add this one, this and this term is same, so this is negative and negative, so I can directly add this become minus 2 log sine 2x, and that will be added separately. So I take it common limit with integral, like 2 log cos x plus 2 log sine x, then minus 2 log sine 2x. Why it comes minus 2 log sine x? Because minus, when I add these two equation, minus 1 and minus 1 become minus 2. Now what I will take? I will take, try to take 2 common outside. So that will be 2, 0 to pi by 2 log cos x plus log sine x, then minus log sine 2x. Mark this in the bracket, so that is x. Okay, now here 2 will be cancelled on both sides. Here log m plus log n. Here you apply log m plus log n property is log m into n. So your required equation will be I is equal to 0 to pi by 2 log sine x cos x, then minus log, now I open it here with the formula, sine 2x formula is 2 sine x cos x and dx. Okay, now here log m minus log n, we apply the rule log m minus log n, that is log m upon n. So I is equal to 0 to pi by 2 log sine x cos x upon 2 sine x cos x dx. So sine x cos x will be cancelled, only 1 by 2 is left. So I is equal to 0 to pi by 2 log 1 by 2 is left. If you saw that log 1 by 2 is a constant term, but first we open again with m upon n form, that is log m minus log n, we separate it, then we integrate further. So that becomes, I directly separate this one, log 1 minus 0 to pi by 2 log 2 dx. So here if you look at log 1 value is 0. Okay, so this part becomes 0. So we will left only minus 0 to pi by 2 log 2 dx. And log 2 is a constant term. We take it outside, only 0 to 1, 0 to pi by 2, 1 dx is left. And integration of 1 with respect to x is x. Then I is equal to minus log 2 x 0 to pi by 2. When I apply the value, my required answer is minus pi by 2 log 2. So that is my required answer in this case. Now one more question, this is of last question of our assignments. So what worksheet I have sent to you. So here in this, if there is also in lower limit, because in previous question only upper limit is given to you and lower limit was given to you 0. Okay, but here in this case you have also proper value of lower limit is given to you and upper limit is given to you. Here we can't apply the direct property of a minus x, because here for applying the a minus x property, your lower limit should be 0. So if it is not 0, so that means you have to apply the another property. Here we have applied the property, like here something is value of a and b fx dx, and your property will be a to b f a plus b minus x dx. That you have to apply the property in this case. So now what I will do, I just pick this equation. Before applying the property, I have to simplify this equation because this is tan x root is there. Okay, so you have to open this tan x into sin x upon cos x. To simplify this equation, I is equal to minus pi by 4, 3 pi by 4. Then when you open this root tan x, that becomes sin x plus cos x root, then 1 plus sin x by cos x root dx. Now when you take the LCM here, so it will be root cos x will be multiplied with here with denominator root cos x, and here also denominator in the numerator fraction also. So denominator will be cancelled. Then my required equation before applying the property is minus pi by 4 to 3 pi by 4 root sin x, then root cos x, then plus root sin x dx. Okay, now I check with the property here. So here is a, so here is b, 3 pi by 4. Now you have to apply this a plus b minus x. You just replace x with, add these two limits and minus x in place of x. So before applying the property, you mark that original equation as 1. So after applying the property, minus pi by 4 to 3 pi by 4 sine minus pi by 4 plus 3 pi by 4, then minus x under square root. Similarly, cos x will be like that, minus pi by 4 plus 3 pi by 4 minus x under square root, then plus sine minus pi by 4 plus 3 pi by 4 minus x under square root dx. Okay, so now if you look at this, minus pi by 4 plus 3 pi by 4, 3 minus 1 gives you 2, 2 by 4 gives you 1 by 2. So that means only pi by 2 minus x is left after solving. Minus pi by 4, 3 pi by 4, so it is left sine pi by 2 minus x. Similarly, in another terms also, cos pi by 2 minus x is left, and here also sine pi by 2 minus x root is left. So now 90 minus x, sine changes to cos and cos changes to sine in form of when it is 90 minus x is there. So minus pi by 4 to 3 pi by 4, that become cos x root sine x root plus cos x root dx. Now here this is my second equation. Now next step, you have to add these two equations. So when you add these two equations, adding equation 1 and equation 2. So when you add these two equations, I plus I become 2i. So I take, because limit is same, so I can take limit as common integral. So that will be sine x. Denominator is same, so I just add the numerator directly. So that becomes sine x root plus cos x root dx. Now here if you look at this, numerator denominator is same, so you can cancel this one. Then 2i is equal to minus pi by 4 to 3 pi by 4, 1 dx is left. Integration of 1 is x, so minus pi by 4 to 3 pi by 4. Now you directly apply the value here, so that is 3 pi by 4, then minus minus pi by 4, because when you apply the low limit, there will be a negative sign between the applying the upper limit and the low limit, so that become positive. Then 2i is equal to 4i, negative negative positive, 4 pi by 4, 4 will be cancelled, and my required answer will be I is equal to pi by 2 after cross multiply. So this is my required answer. Thank you. Have a